not to excuse him. He's a little upset because the company canceled his three-picture deal.
Was that before or after they fired you as my bodyguard?
Just how long have you been playing these cretins?
Cretins?
I don't know.
Just how long?
God! Ah.
Man, don't tell me what to do. We've been here long enough. Since when did you turn into David?
Since you turned back into a cheerleader.
Head cheerleader?
Head cheerleader.
That's right, Rhonda. Head cheerleader.
Yeah, you know, that's the one in charge of all the other cheerleaders.
Hey, would you like more beer?
Yes.
I think you've had enough beer too, don't you?
I'll let you know when I've had enough.
Hey, I've never been kissed by another cheerleader before.
Me neither.
Head cheerleader.
That's right.
Me neither, Cheryl.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Hey, you know, that's a interesting thing in our language. Head cheerleader there, Cheryl. It's an interesting thing, you know, that word head, how in our language, words can take on a whole new meaning. You know, like if you just put a verb in front of head, you give head. See how that works.
Christ.
You know, I think a jerk off is a good one. That could be either a noun or a verb.
Or in this case, a plural noun.
Wait a minute. I'm not quite sure what you're getting at. Do you mean like, let's see, lay something?
Sure. You know, like, lay down a book, lay down the apple, or the apple gets laid down.
Or, lay a person.
Yeah, that's a good one. That one works.
Give me that beer can.
Stop it, Rhonda. I'm trying to think. What could be some more?
What could be some more?
What could be some more?
I have one. Eat it!
Eat it? That's a good one.
Like, eat a thing?
Eat an orange?
Or eat the apple you laid down?
You eat it!
Why don't you, big shot?
There's a million of them. Eat this, eat that, eat them, eat, you know, I don't know.
Eat my snatch.
Oh, oh my God.
Yeah, that's a great one, eat my snatch. Woo,
man. Yeehaw.
How about, purse snatcher?
That's a good one.
Or snatch a lunch break?
No, that's not that good.
That here, that wasn't so good. You know what, get bent. Get bent yourself.
God damn it, Cheryl.
I'm trying to think. Would you be quiet?
I'm not leaving you here alone with them.
Shh. I've got one.
What?
Bush.
Bush? Yeah, the bush. Yeah, bush, sure.
All around the mulberry bush.
The burning bush.
Around bush.
Or Clint's very bush league.
Or how would you like a knuckle sandwich behind the bushes?
Sex behind the bushes.
Anheuser-Busch.
Huh?
What? Right here on this label.
Anheuser-Busch.
Anheuser-Busch, sure, that works.
Right, and how's yours, baby, if you don't mind me asking?
That's it, come on, we're leaving.
Stop it, Rhonda.
Hey.
Honestly.
What? Now, where were we? Quick, think of some more.
I got one. How about cock, huh? How about cock?
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a great one.
Cock fight.
Cocktail.
Cock tat.
Cockatoo.
Cockadoodle-doo.
Or how about half-cocked, huh? Half-cocked.
More cock than yours, asshole.
Or dong.
Dong, sure.
Dongaroonies.
Dong, dong, dong.
Ding, dong, ding, dong.
Who's there?
How?
How long is your dong?
How long is your dong?
I'm gonna riot.
Hey, God. Cheryl. I've got a great old high school word for you.
What's that, Rhonda?
Twat. Twat the hell happened to your promise?
Well, Rhonda.
Oh, no.
I've got one for you.
Another one?
How?
Didn't we already do how? I think so.
No. How would you like to see my room?
What are you doing?
What does it look like under there?
Rooting through the garbage, precious heart.
It's called looking for something to eat.
Well, don't you do anything besides eat?
I haven't eaten yet. I'm still starving.
What was dinner? I mean, that entire thing I just sat through? Just a wonderful dream.
Everything you brought was inedible, honey.
You're a real winner, you know that?
Likewise.
I don't have to sit here. I don't have to sit here and listen to you. Tell you the truth, just here to watch you stuff your face.
Don't do me any favors.
You know, I can go drive off somewhere, grab a burger, you know, play some miniature golf, hang out.
So drive, golf, hang by all means.
I wish I could, but I can't, because, you know, I gotta kill somebody.
With any luck, you'll kill each other. I wouldn't want to miss that.
I just can't believe how he could do this to me.
What's to believe?
I still can't believe how he could do this to me.
It's my fucking room they're in. Fucking.
Don't remind me.
Where am I supposed to sleep?
Ask me if I care.
I just can't believe this.
I don't want to hear it.
I mean, you wait and wait.
I said I don't want to hear it.
Yeah, we gotta stop raining and stop pouring.
Shut up!
Hey!
What was that?
I don't know. It's mine.
Give it to me.
I paid for it. Whatever it is. Ooh, potato salad with no salt on it.
Give it to me.
No.
You're not hungry.
I am now.
Give it to me.
No.
Give it to me.
No, stop. Look out.
Don't
wait,
stop
no.
It. No. Give it to me.
No. Much to you here, you take it.
I hate you.
Fine. Good.
I hate your lousy guts.
Will you just take this potato salad?
I don't want it anymore.
Look, it's just got a little sand on it. You know, you just brush it right off. Look, I'll get you started.
I wouldn't eat potato salad from you if it was the last potato salad in the world.
Well, this isn't the last potato salad in the world, but, you know, it is the last one on this beach, and I just wish that you would take it and just shut off those goddamn waterworks. Look, I'm gonna put this right down beside you. It's got a little sand on it. Brush it right off. You'll eat it when you're ready.
Okay.
This weekend. God, get a new shirt. It's all screwed up. Off of this lousy weekend. Get a new shirt. Get off on Saturday, which, believe me, when you work for my old man, is no sweet picnic, even if he is my old man. And you call up your former asshole best friend, stuck-up son of a bitch, who you haven't seen the entire summer since you got back from school. And then you think to yourself, maybe he forgot your phone number. So you collect this asshole and you cart him away to the Cape fucking Cod. You show him this incredibly gorgeous chick. I mean, she's just beautiful. And you make the first move on her and get her interested, lay out her entire plan, whereby you're going to make it with this chick, and then this happens. This. And then, how does that make me feel?
If that's supposed to be some type of an apology, you're gonna have to do one hell of a lot better.
I don't apologize to you. I don't owe you a damn thing. I blame a lot of this on you.
On me?
On you, on you.
How is that?
Well, she's your friend. You should have taught her some manners.
Since when is my friend my fault? I don't see you doing such a good job with your own lousy friend.
Well, that's different. I mean, I was betrayed.
And what was I? You think I would have even come here if it'd been my own idea? I came here because she needed somebody to talk to. And then look what she does to me. And the worst thing is, the thing that makes me feel the dumbest is that I knew that she wouldn't. Swear to God, I think sometimes she can't even help herself. And you too. I'm sitting around on this beach like some piece of driftwood and talking around me and through me and above me. You know what? I'd rather be betrayed. At least then somebody knows I'm breathing.
Well, you still should have done something to make her stay.
Did you just hear a word that I said?
Yeah, but you should have done something. So, how's that potato salad?
Unopened.
Really?
Yeah.
Want a beer?
Do you always drink like this?
Like what?
Into an alcoholic stupor.
Oh, whenever you get the chance.
Charming.
Don't worry about my drinking, Angel Draws. I drank more beer than you ever saw.
I'm sure.
drunk more beer than you ever heard of.
Yep. That must be quite a sight, you and Paul Newman in a chugging contest.
Shut up about Paul Newman.
I'm sorry, guess you thought we actually believed all that crap.
I knew you didn't believe it. That was all part of my plan.
I see.
I mean, chicks don't care whether or not you're somebody important. I mean, as long as you act like you are. You get them interested or feeling sorry for you. Either way works.
Just make up some lie.
The bigger, the better. I mean, I once told a chick that I was just about to become a priest, and she owed it to Jesus to test out my spiritual purity one last time to see if I was worthy or not.
Sad to say, you flunked her test.
Sad to say, but that's always a good one with the Catholic chicks. Spot a crucifix or something. Or you can make one up that's really outrageous. You know, like, last lap of a Monaco Grand Prix, three-car pileup. In the intensive care unit, paralyzed from the waist down for 3 months. You just got out, and you wanted to find out if you were still a real man. Oh, you just haven't found a girl who cared rather than laugh at you.
Until now, that is.
See, you're catching one.
And they actually believe all this crap?
Believe? What is to believe? You're gonna hang on to this for the rest of your life. This is God's truth. People will believe what they want to believe, and chicks are no different.
So what happens when they don't see any scars in your body?
Well, they'll imagine, or something. I mean, you go to all this trouble to impress them. If they're not, they're still impressed you went to all this trouble to bullshit them. You know, bullshit is the sincerest form of flattery.
Aren't you a little scared of admitting all these top secrets to the enemy?
To you? What difference does that make?
So you've actually done all this stuff?
Plenty of times.
You're lying.
I have.
I don't believe you.
So then don't. See
I think
if I
you
care.
Talk big.
Oh, screw you.
I think you're scared.
Of you?
Of women.
Women? Yeah, right. I'm not scared of women.
Right.
That's the theory. It's convenient for women to believe. A certain type of woman. But you've got no case. I idolize women. I love women. I mean, my whole life is built around women. And that is no bullshit. I mean, if it's one thing I'm not, is scared of women. Confused and pissed off pretty much all the time.
And I think scared.
Well, you know what? I think you're scared. Sugar tits, you got it. What do you say about that?
Scared little boy, you live on big schemes and wet dreams.
And what do you live on, sister?
Do you want any of this potato salad or what?
Yeah, I'm not hungry.
Clint, are you okay?
Are you expecting a storm?